Welcome, I'm Natasha. Here we make straightforward and easy meals following Dr. Sebi's nutritional guide. Hey, if you're new here, please download the 5-day Alkaline meal plan below. It helps you stay on this journey, and it's for beginners, and it's free. So don't forget to click the link below. So today we're going to make some alkaline cinnamon rolls. Let's go and do that. Okay, I forgot to mention that these cinnamon buns only take 5 ingredients, and that's including the spring water that goes with them. So the first step you need to do is to make the dough. So for the dough, it's 1 cup of Kamut flour, and then about 1 teaspoon of sea salt. And then you mix those together, and then you can add 1/2 cup of spring water. And then you mix that until you get the nice dough. You don't want this dough to be sticky. You do want it to be easy to touch when you are done with it. And that's all you need for the dough. This dough is one of my favorite doughs to make. I use it for my tortillas. I use it for my meat pies. My apple turnovers is also what I use this dough for. Okay, after you get this dough nicely combined, then you're going to put it to the side, and then you're going to grease or oil your muffin pans. So I use avocado oil to oil my pans here. You can use any oil you have. If you have a silicone mold, you don't even need to use any oil at all. So I grease here all 6 of them. Next time I think I'll make this into 4 instead of 6, and you'll see in a minute why I think that. So for my birthday this year, I got this cool rolling pan, and so I'm just showing you here the different parts of it. It's this metal bar, and it has these different rubber tips, and the rubber parts helps you be able to have a nice even rolled out dough. So I use a thicker part, because I want this dough to be a little thick. So this is about 1/4 inch thickness. And I'm just rolling it out into like a rectangle. So not a circle, but more of a rectangle shape. I definitely eyeballed this. I didn't do it as a measurement, but I was saying, okay, I want to get 6 cinnamon rolls out of this. So this is how I'm just eyeballing it and making sure that I get it to the right measurement of my eye can see. Okay, once you get it rolled out to the way that you want, then you're going to brush on the agave syrup. So I use about 4 tablespoons of agave syrup here, and I just brush it in and make sure I got every piece in every corner of agave syrup. You can use coconut sugar or date sugar if you like. At this moment, I had agave that was available, so I decided to brush on some agave. Then you'll sprinkle on your cinnamon. So I did put a little too much cinnamon here, but it was still, it tastes really good. And then you're going to roll it up like you're rolling up a burrito. You just keep rolling up those sides. And then I cut the rolls in half, and then I cut each half into thirds to make it into the 6 cinnamon rolls. So next time I'll cut these into halves and then halves again so that I can fill my muffin pan a lot easier than it did here. But it came out good and it was delicious. So now you're going to bake them at 350 for 15 minutes. Okay, once they're done, I did let them cool down for about a minute or so. And then after it cooled down, we ate it with more agave syrup on top. You do want to eat these hot because once they cool down, you don't really taste the agave syrup in between. You just taste just the cinnamon. So that's why I knew I used a little too much cinnamon, because once it cooled, they were like you barely could taste the agave. But these were yummy and they were quick to put together and my kids loved them. So a bonus is you can make these into 2 big cinnamon buns. So instead of rolls, you can have buns. So you make the dough the same way, and then you will put the agave and cinnamon on top. And then instead of rolling it, you'll cut them into pieces. So instead of cutting it after you roll it, you're going to cut it before. So you'll cut it in half, and then you cut each half into thirds. Then you'll start with the outside piece first and you'll roll it up, and then you'll roll the next piece around that one and the next piece around that one. So technically you can make 1 big cinnamon bun here, but I made it into 2. And then I baked it for about 25 minutes. So you do need to bake them a little longer, and you'll bake it at 350 for about 25 minutes. Look at it. So remember, if you want it gooey, you let it cook a little less. So that's how you can make cinnamon buns instead of cinnamon rolls. Hey, thank you for sticking to the end. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. If you want to stay up to date with what I do here in this channel, please subscribe below. And if you do like what you have seen, please watch more videos here. Okay, have a good day. Bye.